By now, you may have noticed that social media influencers live suspiciously amazing lives. You may not have noticed that the shady tactics of social media influencers go much deeper and much darker than product placement and funded holidays. They're often caught promoting scams, fake lifestyles, or dangerous products, and little is being done to stop it. Let's take a dive into the dirty secrets, scandals, and deceit that social media influencers don't want you to know about. Secretive sponsorships. Social media influencers have a massive impact in developing trends and promoting new products to a captive audience. 92% of consumers around the world say they trust word of mouth and recommendations from friends and family above all other forms of advertising. For companies, getting an influencer on board is simply a shortcut to word of mouth praise, as many users, consciously or not, perceive the influencers they follow as friends and trust them. On top of earning visibility, the top influencers can make ridiculous amounts of money for their social media posts. Kylie Jenner is rumored to earn $1 million for every sponsored Instagram post. For the exposure influencers can allow, companies are willing to pay top dollar, and it's clear why. A recent study conducted by Twitter suggested that about 40% of social media users have purchased an item online after seeing it used by a social media content creator, compared to a 2% average for regular online ads. And amazingly, for every dollar invested into influencer marketing, businesses generally get about $6.50 in return. However, the growing popularity of influencers has created a mountain of issues and controversies which their audiences are not always aware of. The lack of clear, enforced international transparency laws means influencers can post misleading or false information about products or services without facing consequences. They aren't held to the same standards of truth as traditional advertisers, which are strictly policed by national and international authorities. Equally important is the fact that influencers will often frame endorsements and advertisements in ways that make it difficult to realize you're seeing an ad at all. A 2018 survey by Collective Edge discovered that only 38% of paid-for brand collaborations were disclosed as an ad or sponsored post to the audience. In January 2019, 16 British celebrities pledged to the Competition and Marketing Authority to be clear in their posts about which items they paid for versus items were provided for free in exchange for their endorsement. This movement came about after nearly 300 influencers were formally cautioned by the Advertising Standards Authority for their lack of disclosure surrounding paid adverts. Similar regulations are in place in Ireland and the United Arab Emirates, but there is still a lack of international regulation for making it clear which posts are paid adverts. In the US, an advocacy group, Truth in Advertising, collected 1,700 posts from 50 influencers which were sponsored by Ciroc Vodka, but displayed minimal to zero disclosure about their paid status. Included in this group were P. Diddy, Ashanti, and Bow Wow. The advocacy group have sent their evidence to the Federal Trade Commission in hopes that the federal body will take enforcement action against those who mislead audiences. But as of now, nothing has changed. Scams and snake oil. Even worse than concealed advertisements are endorsements that turn out to be full-blown scams. Scams that sometimes even the influencers fall for. In 2018, a class-action lawsuit was filed against boxer Floyd Mayweather Jr. and music producer DJ Khaled by a group of people who had invested in Centra Tech, a company that sold cryptocurrency-related products. These celebrity influencers strongly endorsed Centra Tech on social media. DJ Khaled called it a game-changer, and Mayweather nicknamed himself Floyd Crypto Mayweather. The crux of the issue became clear when the founders of Centra Tech were indicted with 4 counts of fraud against their investors, once the nature of their scam came to light. The lawsuit against the celebrity influencers alleges that as a result of their promotion and apparent trust, over $32 million was invested into the company before its dramatic failure. In late 2018, both Mayweather and Khaled were forced to pay over $400,000 to the plaintiffs, despite their claims of ignorance about the nature of the scam. This dramatic episode served to highlight how influencers are often as easily fooled by scams as the rest of us. Their true danger lies in the influence that, unlike most of us, they have over millions of potentially misguided consumers. In some cases, the influencer is the scammer themselves. Aggie Lal, an Instagrammer with 1 million followers, started a 12-week course which promised to teach students how they could become a wealthy travel blogger. She charged $500 for a class and grossed nearly $200,000 from the 380 people who signed up. Participants told BuzzFeed the course fell far short of expectations. expectations and was not what Lal advertised. The course resembled a pyramid scheme, with Lal attempting to get her customers to become salespeople for the class, and eventually she stopped posting instructional videos altogether. Some refunds were eventually issued, but Lal never admitted to any wrongdoing. There's a growing trend for influencers to push diet-related products like pills, waist trainers, fit teas, and fat-burning injections. They advertise these products as a miracle cure with magic health benefits, all for an affordable price, with convenient discount codes or subscription plans. In reality, most of these products are not fully tested, regulated, or FDA approved. Reminiscent of the unregulated nonsense pushed by advertisers in the early 20th century, many of these diet products contain laxatives or stimulants which can cause irregular heartbeats and muscle cramps, or mess with the digestive system. Their benefits, if any, are limited, and the long-term negative effects are unknown. Influencers don't share any of the potential dangers or warnings with their followers, yet aren't held responsible if they get sick. Influencer fitness companies are also questionable, and many scams flat-out steal from fans. Popular fitness Instagrammer Brittany Dawn Fitness sold nutrition and training guides for $300 each, but failed to provide the items. When angry followers sought refunds, they were met with refusals or asked to sign non-disclosure agreements. Despite widespread complaints, Brittany failed to refund all customers, but instead posted a YouTube video about how she would learn and grow from the experience. Hopefully, she'll be able to learn and grow from the comfort of a jail cell, once this kind of scamming is cracked down on. Health crisis. The link between social media and health is a hotly debated topic. The recent horror stories of HIV infection caused by unhygienic vampire facials, a trend popularized by Kim Kardashian, are just the tip of the iceberg. Kendall Jenner recently posted an emotional video hinting at an upcoming announcement. The announcement was promised to relate to a difficult struggle she wanted to help with, leading people to believe she would be raising awareness about mental health.
Like, I can help you, and it's okay.
Her own mother tweeted about how brave and vulnerable Kendall's endeavor was, and how the mysterious announcement would heroically help others. The video was, in fact, just a paid advertisement for Kendall's new collaboration with Proactive Acne Cream. It's hard to deny that Kris and Kendall clearly took advantage of the type of language surrounding a current social issue, not to mention the skin condition of acne, as a way to make more money. But the psychology of social media goes deeper. A study published in Psychology of Popular Media Culture has revealed some scary details about the impact of Instagram on our mental health. Because of the visual nature of the app and constant barrage of perfect influencer images, Instagram has a significantly higher link between usage and mental distress than other social media platforms. The study's author suggests that this is because Instagram affects the way we compare our lives to others. We have immediate access to idealized images created by influencers, which don't accurately represent an attainable life. The pressures put on young people's self-perception by social media can be illustrated by a few graphs. Have a look at this one, which shows rates of kids aged 12 through 17 who met the criteria for having a major depressive episode in America. As you can see, rates have shot up since 2010, as more and more kids started to use social media platforms. 2007 was the year iPhones arrived, and by 2011, around half of American teenagers had a smartphone and access to social media in middle school. We can't yet claim to know the exact causal link, but it would make sense. It's thought girls are more vulnerable, since their appearance may be a greater indicator of their perceived self-worth than males, and they may be more likely to suffer from FOMO. On top of that, female aggression seems to be geared towards damaging social relationships, whereas boys prefer to just punch each other in the face. Social media and smartphones, therefore, hypercharge the type of aggression and bullying girls find particularly painful. What's particularly terrifying is this seems to lead to self-harm. These graphs show self-harm rates for girls and boys from three different increasing age groups over time. As you can see, rates of self-harm are relatively consistent for males, but for females, they increased at higher rates for each subsequently younger group of females over the last 7 years to 2015. It makes sense that social media may be the trigger, since the oldest group of adults didn't grow up with social media, but younger kids are now exposed to it. It may be time to stop really young kids from using social media. As you'll see, it's setting impossible standards that don't fully mirror reality. The influencers posting pictures on the beach are probably lying to you in a number of ways. Altered beings. It's not unrealistic to suggest that influencers tend to fit into certain categories: sun-kissed, slim, and with few imperfections. What is unrealistic, however, is the impression that influencer appearances are easily attainable. Influencers are not required to show the reality of achieving these standards through surgery, expensive training, dangerous diets, and worst of all, Photoshop. The need to show perfect images reached ridiculous heights when Kim Kardashian was accused of photoshopping her 5-year-old daughter's body to make her look thinner and lighter skinned. There are countless images of Kim and her fellow Kardashian Jenners, alongside an endless stream of other influencers who have been caught out digitally modifying the shapes of their bodies. You'd be surprised at how prevalent this is, and more so at how easily it can be done. Using the Liquify tool on Photoshop, it's as simple as clicking and dragging. It's not all a girl's game, though. Male influencers like Jake Paul have been found guilty too. Jake gave his shoulders some extra pump, but forgot to fill in the extra muscle. Whoops. Travel blogger Amelia Liana lost almost 450,000 followers after obviously photoshopped images appeared on her Instagram in 2017. One snap of the New York skyline was suspiciously lacking the Freedom Tower, suggesting she had used an out-of-date stock photo as the background. A pic of the Taj Mahal lacked scaffolding that was present at the time, and had birds added in for a picturesque effect. Others have gone even further, photoshopping themselves into a whole new life. Swedish influencer Johanna Olsen posted a series of Instagram photos showing her on a luxury holiday to Paris, but closer inspection revealed the truth. It was clear that she had just edited herself into the images. She claimed she was actually in the city and simply touched up the images, but the obvious difference in lighting and clearly cut edges suggested she lied about the whole trip. If you weren't already hesitant to believe your eyes while scrolling through your feed, you should be now. Fakery. In general, influencers demonstrate a lifestyle which is unattainable for most of their followers. There is no real motivation for them to be honest about the sources of their income or the story behind their posts. As a result, they can rent private jets or style departments just for the photo opportunities, or can be gifted access to exclusive things that they otherwise could not afford. We all have heard of car rentals, but in Russia, a photography studio now rents out their private jet by the hour to influencers who want to exude the impression of a rich and famous lifestyle. For $200, they can pose with the plane and enjoy its sleek interior, getting all the travel photos they need without ever leaving the ground. Influencers rent apartments for their snaps too. An exclusive and carefully decorated Soho apartment has a waiting list of over 1,000 people who just want to use it as a pretty background for their posts. In an expensive city like New York, this allows them to pretend they have a lifestyle which they realistically could not afford. But they never disclose this reality to their followers, though at this point its common usage has left it pretty recognizable. Many influencers advertise themselves as single entrepreneurs who run multiple successful businesses, while also traveling and having an amazing personal life. In reality, they are supported by a large behind-the-scenes team of assistants, publicists, lawyers, and advisors. Influencers are a huge and unstoppable phenomenon, which are hugely influential for their millions of followers, but they are presenting a brand and a script reality rather than providing the whole story. I'm not saying it's wrong to digitally alter photos or to turn your body and personality into a brand, but it pays for followers to know what's going on. The real concern lies in the serious controversy surrounding influencers, which have shown a light on their questionable practices and moral issues. So followers need to be ever vigilant for scams and remember that reality is not the same as what is shown on the internet. But don't breathe a sigh of relief just yet. This is just the tip of the iceberg. Comment below if you want me to make a follow-up video with even more shocking secrets influencers won't tell you. Also, which messed up secret did you find most disturbing? Do you have dirt of your own to dish on disingenuous influencers? Let me know in the comment section down below, and thanks for watching.